am reading, in my bed reading, and I'm reading this book, and it's called Learning to Be, and it's by my minister, Juanita Rasmus, and God, it's so informative, and it's so amazing, and it's about mental health, and just her having a crash, and after being a perfectionist for so many years, and requiring so much, and I mean, it's just really got me emotional.
Well, it is Faith Friday here at ABC and GMA3, and that was Beyonce's mama. That's Tina Knowles Lawson praising our next guest's book. Juanita Campbell Rasmus is a pastor at St. John's United Methodist Church in Houston, and yes, that is the home church of Beyonce and the entire Knowles family.
That's right, and she is here now to tell us all about that book titled Learning to Be, Finding Your Center After the Bottom Falls Out. So please welcome Pastor Juanita Campbell Rasmus. Thank you so much for being with us, Pastor. And I know you're not only just a spiritual guide for Tina Knowles Lawson, she actually has some very special ties to your book. Tell us about them.
Well, actually, she wrote the foreword for me, so I'm so grateful to her for doing so.
Why did you want to write it in the first place? What is it you wanted to get out?
Well, you know, there are a number of things. Number one, I wanted to help tear down the walls around shame and the stigma as it relates to a mental health diagnosis. And then the second thing, and I think this is really critical, is that I want to say to people who have received a mental health diagnosis, you can live with the diagnosis. So often we are surrounded with so much shame, so much that we'll have to change. But what I want to say to people who are experiencing mental health challenges, and right now during COVID-19, many of us are, I want to say, embrace the change. It's an opportunity to change some of the formulas you've been using for your life, maybe change some boundaries, set some new desires and some new goals based on new information.
I love that, something we all need to hear. And you are so candid, so vulnerable in this. You had a major depressive episode more than 20 years ago. Why do you think it's so important now to share your story?
Well, you know, with COVID-19, we're all not only experiencing potentially some financial changes, we're certainly experiencing social changes, but we're also all experiencing some mental and emotional changes. Just ask any mom who's at home trying to work and also homeschool her children. There is a need for the practices that are included in Learning to Be.
Okay, wrapping up a week, going into the weekend, please, for our viewers, give us all something we can take into the weekend, a message for us.
Here's one thing I'd like to encourage you to do. Matter of fact, make it two. Number one, get out in nature as best you're able. Get some fresh air, increase the vitamin D. Walk, run, jog, whatever you can do, plan your garden. The second thing is this. Tonight, before you go to bed, I'd like you to reflect on something that gave you life today. Maybe it was eating your favorite treat or talking to a friend on the phone. And then do more of the things that give you life. It's critical for our mental health and our well-being, especially now.
That is beautiful. Amen to that, right? We can do both of those things.
We can do that. That's easy. Thank you so much, Pastor Rasmus. It is so good to see you. Congrats on the book. And we are hoping we can see you down the road, maybe on a Faith Friday. Maybe we need Faith Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday.
Yes, thank you.
I'm available. Just call. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.